Today we are discussing about menstrual cycle. This menstrual cycle, it is the characteristic feature of, of primates. And under the primates, it includes humans and apes. So these are the organisms we show a cycle, that is known as the menstrual cycle. This menstrual cycle occurs due to the change, in the female reproductive system, What are the changes which take place in the female reproductive system? At puberty, the hypothalamus, that is when a girl child attains the age of puberty, the hypothalamus secretes the hormone. That hormone is known as gonadotropin releasing hormone, we are short form, that is GnRH. And this gonadotropin releasing hormone activates the anterior lobe of pituitary. Pituitary gland. And then this pituitary gland secretes two hormones. One is luteinizing hormone and second one is follicle stimulating hormone. Now these two hormones, that is the luteinizing hormone and the follicle stimulating hormone, they have a target set, that is known as the ovary. That means they will work or they will activate the ovary, which is acting as an endocrine gland. Now this ovary will have a cycle, onset of cycle, or this female reproductive system will show the cycle, that is known as the menstrual cycle. So the hormones responsible for that is the luteinizing hormone and follicle stimulating hormone, which are secreted by the anterior lobe of pituitary. So hypothalamus gets activated at puberty to secrete gonadotropin releasing hormone, which activates the anterior lobe of pituitary to secrete luteinizing hormone and follicle stimulating hormone, which will activate the ovary, and that will lead to the cycle. We call that cycle as a menstrual cycle. One more important thing is that is this menstrual cycle is actually the series of events. It's a series of events, that is the biological events, which last for 28 days. Then there are the various events which first take place. Then after, there is the onset of the cycle after 28 days. We call that cycle as a menstrual cycle. So it's actually a series of events which first take place. That is a, like we have a the first one is the follicular phase, then after we have a ovulatory phase, then after we have a luteal phase, then after we have onset of the cycle, that is known as the menstrual cycle. Now, one more important thing you have to keep in mind, that is this cycle, this menstrual cycle is suspended. It is suspended or arrested during pregnancy and lactation period. So these are the two periods where you will see the pregnancy or suspended, this menstrual cycle do not take place. They are suspended during lactation and during pregnancy, what we call this period. So in these two periods, this menstrual cycle is suspended. Now one more important thing which you have to keep in mind, that is the first menstrual cycle takes place, it begins at puberty and ends at menopause. It completely stops at menopause. You have to keep in mind, the age of the female is at menopause is 50 to 55 years. It is the age where the menstrual cycle completely stops. What happens during menstrual cycle, you have to keep in mind, in a menstrual cycle, the endometrium, that is the inner lining of the uterus, and the secondary oocyte, which is formed there, which is transported there into the uterus, now both get broken down or they get degenerated, and they come out through the vagina in the form of a liquid, in the form of blood. We call that, that time we can call that cycle as a menstrual cycle. And this menstrual cycle, it may be shorter in certain females, or it may be longer in certain females, but its average time, it remains up to 4 to 5 days. So it remains, this menstrual cycle, it remains for 4 to 5 days, which you have to keep in mind. Now, what are the various changes which a female shows during the menopause, that when it attains the age of 50 to 55 years? What are the various changes which we see during the menopause in a female? Here are the various changes. Let's discuss them. What are the changes during menopause? That means when a female attains the age of 50 to 55. Now, the first change which we see, that there is a decrease in estrogen level. That means estrogen level is going on decreasing. There is a hot flush. Then after, there is a mood swing. Mood gets changed. Mood swing. It changes. Or we can simply say the estrogen becomes zero. Testosterone is created. Testosterone is secreted, and there is an appearance of, hair on face. You see the facial hair, it's growing here on the face, that will appear because of the secretion of the hormone that is known as the testosterone, which gets secreted. So these are the various changes which you see in the female during the menopause. And the first menstrual cycle is called as menarche. Menarche is the first which takes place at the puberty, menarche, and it lasts up to the menopause. After menopause, there is no menstrual cycle. Now, one more important thing you have to keep in mind, the menstrual cycle occurs in various phases. We will discuss it in various phases. So, as to understand the process completely, how it takes place and what are the various changes which take place in a female reproductive system. And we will discuss them in detail, but let's have a brief idea about it. The first phase, so we have the various phases of menstrual cycle, so we have the various phases. The first phase which we have, that is known as, let's take the, it's only having the three phases, but we'll discuss the one more additional phase, that's the menstrual phase. See, for instance, if a menstrual phase takes place, now we have the menstrual cycle, it's taking place first. This menstrual phase or menstrual cycle, it remains up to 4 to 5 days. That means now it has been complete. Now there is no menstrual cycle, it has stopped now. Now blood screen. Now what will happen after that? There will be the one more phase which will take place in an ovary, that is a follicular phase. And this follicular phase, it lasts about for 10 to 14 days. Then follicular phase has been completed. Now next phase will be our ovulatory phase. And this ovulatory phase, it will occur on the 14th day. This takes place on the 14th day. Now, this is only the one day where the ovulation takes place, we call that day the 14th day, that is known as the ovulatory phase, where the egg is released into the oviduct. Then afterward, the next phase which takes place, that is known as the luteal phase. Or we can also call it the secretory phase. While you will see there is a formation of corpus luteum, and it remains from 15th to 28th day. If the fertilization do not take place, then after luteal phase, there will be the menstrual phase. And menstrual cycle takes place, it remains for 4 to 5. If pregnancy takes place, then there is no menstrual cycle. So you have kept in mind, the luteal phase is the phase where the corpus luteum is formed. That remains for 15th day to 28th day, okay? And if the fertilization do not take place, what happens is the onset of a cycle. We call that cycle as a menstrual. This is a brief idea about the way this phases which take place in a menstrual cycle. Let's have tomorrow let's tomorrow discuss them in detail, and we'll see the various changes which take place in a female reproductive system.